is the Fresh Off the Hook family, F-O-T-H-F, a family of crocheters displaying the talent that has been given to us from above. Fresh Off the Hook.
Welcome to this video. It is me, OVW, and this is Fresh Off the Hook Friday. You guys, this should have been recorded like 2.5 weeks ago, but I had computer issues. Now I have a new computer. My husband blessed me with a new computer, so that issue is settled and done with. I still have internet issues, and I still need a new camera, so 1 out of 3 is not that bad. It's a start, but I got a new computer here. Do I look clear? This is an upgrade from the computer I had. I had a 22-inch iMac, and now I have a 27-inch iMac, which is upgraded with all the latest softwares, and so, yes, HD quality. Here we are. So, thanks for tuning into this video. Give it a thumbs up, because this is my second Fresh Off the Hook of this year. Yes. So, go ahead and get started. I didn't do that much crocheting, so this is going to be a pretty short Fresh Off the Hook. But yes, at least I'm doing another Fresh Off the Hook, right? So just thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sticking with me. And just don't forget to like this video now, because I'm going to show you some pretty cool stuff. And yes, there will be tutorials on these items, most of them at least. So first off, you guys know of the tutorial of the Hearty Beanie, the Heart Love Beanie. You definitely want to check it out. I have them in 2 different sizes, which is for Azaria and I. And this is an upcoming tutorial. This was requested by Jody. And so you will see that, I believe coming up this Tuesday, you will see this tutorial on this. Or it might be sooner. I don't know. But I don't know if I'll have the bottom like this. It'll be plain. But this is like the crocodile stitch hand cozy. All right. Let me put it on so you can see here. Let me slip it on. I don't know what you call them, but I guess it was a fad going around, or there was someone who made some going around. And so she sent me a picture through text, and I just created. Say hi, Buttercup. Say hi, everybody. Okay, so let mommy record. Thank you. So here it is here. Yeah, so there's a couple of mistakes that I've done on this, but it'll be better for the tutorial, okay? I think I'm just going to change up the yarn and everything. So this will just be my test piece. And then I will read this to make my other one, okay? So that there. Also, I was looking at an Italian video, and I guess from... I know I'm starting to learn how to count. I think it's like 1, 2, 3. So I'm starting to learn the numbers in Italian. Here, you want your water? Mm-hmm. Okay, go out. So I was watching an Italian tutorial, and I pretty much figured it out how to do this stitch. And so I made it into a beanie, and this is for Azaria. I have to make me one. So for the tutorial, I will be making one to fit me. But here's a picture of Buttercup wearing it. This is so cute. I don't know what to call it. Just the pineapple go around beanie. It could be pineapples or strawberries, or I would say strawberries, not pineapple. Even though it's like the pineapple stitch, they kind of look like strawberries. Using the front post, double crochet in it, and chaining. Pretty much that's all you are doing, all right? And this came out really, really cute, and I just made the little pom-pom to go on top. So I really like this one. I'm going to have to make me one because it's just too cute. All right, then the next one, I learned the Celtic stitch, and so I've seen cows done in it, but I haven't seen a hat made in it. So I made a beanie with the Celtic stitch. Yeah, this takes up a lot of yarn. I used the Karen Cakes, and it took up a lot of yarn because you're doing the front and back post. But this came out really, really nice. I guess I'll try it on so you guys can see. Okay. My braids make it kind of tight, but it'll stretch out. I do have elastic in it. But yeah, that is the beanie there. to show you guys. I really like this stitch. It's kind of like basket weave kind of stitch. I really, really like it. And so it was kind of cool because as I was doing the rows, they automatically changed color on its own. So it striped the color using the Karen Cake. It striped the color itself. And then I just kind of went with the rest of this purple here. I just did the bottom row which covered the elastic. But if you can see the stitch, it's called the Celtic Stitch using the triple crochet. So stay tuned for this upcoming tutorial. And then I think the last fresh off the hook, I was trying out yarn pulling. And so I made this scarf for Buttercup, which is all it is using the moss stitch, which is single crochet, chain one, single crochet. And it made this unique pattern. Okay, so there's doing nothing but the moss stitch, that's it. And because this yarn is variegated, the yarn created this pattern itself, which is really, really pretty. So now I just have to make her a hat to match. But it was fun to do. I have tried some other yarn pulling, which sometimes it's very difficult. You have to know the technique in order to get the right pattern. So yeah, this came out really, really nice. It's really long. So this is even long enough for me, but I made it for Buttercup and she said she liked it. It's warm and cozy. So Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention that is still kind of fresh on the hook is this heart shawl. Can you see the hearts? Isn't that cute? Now, will I wear this? No, I'm not really a shawl person. I just saw it and I had to do it. But it's really, really pretty. You can see the little hearts on here. I'm finally using some yarn from Yarn Box. There was 3 balls like this and this is my 3rd one. So I'm pretty much going to do this shawl until the yarn runs out. And see how big it comes out. I still have to block it, so it's still going to be a little bit bigger when I'm done. So, but yeah, this is the heart shawl. So let me know if you want a tutorial on this. I saw a graph on Pinterest with the picture of the shawl, and so I just kind of looked at the graph and figured it out. So if you want a tutorial, let me know. I'm not sure if there's any tutorials out there. There may be. Maybe if you type in heart shawl, but if you want me to do a tutorial, just let me know. This is really, really cute. I can't wait till I finish. I'm going to put this in my Etsy shop, but yeah, it was really, really pretty and I'm loving this variegated yarn from Yarn Box. So yeah, that's it for my fresh off the hook. And I want to thank everybody for watching. Give it a thumbs up and let's get this to at least 100 likes, please. And that way I know that you guys love watching the Fresh Off the Hooks and that I need to really keep them coming. All right. So thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up and I will see you guys in the next video. Love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first and everything else second. Bye. And thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to check out my previous video when I open up my November yarn box and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.